Sister Deidre Byrne and Abby Johnson are coming up, but first, some news. In his weekly catechesis, Pope Francis lamented the social inequality caused by the global pandemic. According to the Pope, quote, "These symptoms of inequality reveal a social illness. It is a virus that comes from a sick economy, the result of unequal economic growth, which disregards human values." And Pope Francis will resume his public weekly general audiences on Wednesday, September 2nd. This according to the Vatican. The Pope will address a small group of the faithful in the San Damaso courtyard of the Apostolic Palace. In March, the Vatican moved all Wednesday audiences from St. Peter's Square to a private library of the Apostolic Palace due to the pandemic. The prefectura of the papal household assures us that all COVID-19 directives will be followed.
As followers of Christ, we are called to stand up for life against the politically correct or fashionable of today. We must fight against a legislative agenda that supports and even celebrates destroying life in the womb. Keep in mind, the laws we create define how we see our humanity. And we must ask ourselves, what are we saying when we go into a womb and snuff out an innocent, powerless, voiceless life? As a physician, I can say without hesitation, life begins at conception.
That was Sister Deidre Byrne. She was speaking from the Republican Convention on Wednesday. Sister Dede is a retired Army surgeon and a sister of the Little Workers of the Sacred Hearts of Jesus and Mary here in Washington, D.C. I'm very pleased to welcome her to the program this evening. Sister Dede, thank you for being here. You said you asked God, you prayed to him, to allow you to be a voice and an instrument for human life. Then you got this call from the RNC. Why make a request like that of God? What do you think brought you to that?
For the most part, my prayer was, Lord, use me in any way I can. You know, please, we need to be more of a voice to reach out to our Catholics who, there's a lot of confusion out there with many Catholics who are good people, but they're not, you know, real clear on the Catholic theology and that life, the life issues would be to them equal to immigration, whatever.
Right.
The bishops don't say that. Life is number one. And as Mother Teresa said, you know, at the Catholic prayer or the prayer breakfast many years ago, God rest her soul, St. Teresa of Calcutta, you know, any country that doesn't support life, we have to be wary. You know, something, we're going to be headed down that road of perdition. So my prayer was just, Lord, use me in any way. And that was the same prayer I used before I entered the religious life. Lord, use me in what it, please give me the strength and the joy and the desire to serve you. And then that same day, I got a call from the White House asking, would I be willing to speak? And I, you know, I thought, boy, God really answered this this prayer pretty quickly.
He picked up fast for you. Pretty good.
So I said, if this is, I really felt this was God asking me to do this. And so I couldn't say no. I can't say no.
As a retired colonel in the U.S. Army Medical Corps and as a reservist, now a religious sister, you left nothing to the imagination in this speech, particularly this bit. Listen.
I'm not just pro-life, I'm pro-eternal life, and I want all of us to end up in heaven together someday. Which brings me to why I'm here today. Donald Trump is the most pro-life president that this nation has ever had, defending life at all stages. His belief in the sanctity of life transcends politics. President Trump will stand up against Biden-Harris, who are the most anti-life presidential ticket ever, even supporting the horrors of late-term abortion and infanticide.
Now, Sister Dede, some will say you're being partisan there. Your response?
I'm just saying facts. President Trump has been the most supportive pro-life president. You know, Bishop Tyler has said that. I mean, Bishop Strickland said that. Yeah. Cardinal Burke. I'm just another little voice. Life that begins at conception is very important.
At last week's DNC convention, Father James Martin and Sister Simone Campbell were among the faith leaders featured. Sister Simone's an executive of the network. It's a lobby, a Catholic social justice lobby. In a recent Catholic news agency interview, she was asked whether her organization opposes the legal protection of abortion. She said, "This is not our issue. That is not it. It is above my pay grade." What did you think as you watched Sister Simone and Father Martin at the DNC last week?
Well, I'm not here to judge anybody's heart.
Mm-hmm. No, we can't do that.
As I say, you know, as Catholics and as Christians, we have to be, that issue of life is so important. And we should be able to, without hesitation, say and proclaim the importance of the little child in the womb, whether they're, no matter their color, their creed, whatever.
A fellow speaker at the RNC this week was legendary Notre Dame football coach Lou Holtz. He made waves by addressing Joe Biden's Catholicism. He also received criticism in Catholic circles, including the aforementioned Father James Martin. Take a look. I want your reaction to this.
The Biden-Harris ticket is the most radically pro-abortion campaign in history. They and other politicians are Catholics in name only and abandon innocent lives. President Trump protects those lives.
I don't think you should say that about anybody. You cannot, I mean, Lou Holtz may be a terrific football coach, but he cannot look into the soul of Joe Biden. Catholics are also not one-issue voters. Certainly Joe Biden disagrees with church teaching on abortion, but you know, the Trump administration disagrees with church teaching on all sorts of other things.
Sister, your thoughts on this. Can Catholics engage in this moral horse trading at the ballot? Let's talk about that first. Father Martin saying, oh, we're not one-issue voters. Your take.
But it's more than one. I think we have to have, we all prioritize our issues. We must put life as number one. But there's so many other issues that are also important. You know, the freedom of speech, where that young man, Nick Sandman,
yep,
who's
Nick Sandman.
Awesome, he spoke. That's a big important issue of those little sisters of the poor and what they've had to go through. They're our neighbors. I love them. And they have really been attacked because of the religious freedom issue.
Yeah.
They all blend in together. It's life is like the cement on the bottom of a house. And if you don't plan a house on cement, it's going to crumble. And so life comes with, from there comes all these other issues, the issue of religious freedom, protecting the border. We have to take care of those. I spend my life taking care of immigrants. I just did surgery yesterday on a young woman who doesn't speak English. We have, as Catholics, we're called to serve the poorest and care for them, but we also, the number one is the unborn.
I think it's twisting reality to say that Lou Holtz or you are judging Joe Biden's heart. We can't judge his heart. We can judge his public policies, his statements, and the 47-year public record of Joe Biden, which incidentally, he used to be for the Hyde Amendment. He used to be for the Mexico City policy. That is no longer the Joe Biden of today. So we've got to say that. And there's no sin in saying your public manifestation of this issue, abortion advocacy, is profound. And we take notice of it and we'll vote accordingly.
You know, Pope Benedict sent a letter many years ago, and a certain cardinal now, won't name his name, said that any politician that publicly promotes an issue that's against our Catholic faith cannot receive communion.
Right.
That's almost like a level of excommunication in a sense. Mm. You know, no one is told they can't go to Mass or go to confession. In fact, that would be the number one thing we all should do. But you shouldn't receive our Lord.
Before I let you go, what has been the reaction? What are you hearing? For the reaction to your speech, and what do you hope it accomplishes ultimately?
The reaction of the speech has been 95%, I guess. I mean, wonderful. People have been grateful, and there's a lot of people praying, and they're more excited than ever to support a pro-life agenda.
Sister Dede Byrne, yeah. I wish we had another hour. You are incredible. Thank you for being here. And you can follow Sister Dede Byrne and the work of the Little Workers of the Sacred Hearts of Jesus and Mary at their website, littleworkersofthesacredhearts.org. Sister, thank you again.
Thank you, Raymond. God bless you.